Welcome to you students. Today I'd like to introduce to you the subject of economics. And for this, we'll try to discuss about the various definitions and the scope of the study and also the methodology that we are going to use in analyzing economic problems. The word economy comes from the Greek word Economos, which means a person who runs a household. In the first instance, this might sound peculiar, but in fact, there are a lots of things which are common in between households and the economy. Just as a household is faced with many decisions, it has to decide, for example, who will cook food? Who will look after the making of clothing? Or who will look after the TV programs that should be watched? And so on. And therefore, just as a household has to take care of what each person in the family has to do and what he will get in return, the economy also is faced with many decisions. It has to decide what jobs have to be done and by whom. For example, it has to decide who will grow food in the economy, who will take up different jobs like writing computer programs and so on. And therefore, the work in an economy has to be distributed in accordance with the aspiration and the capabilities of people. The use of resources becomes a very important factor because resources are scarce. Because these resources are scarce, an economy cannot fulfill all the needs of the people. And therefore, it has to decide what is to be produced and in what quantity. So the problem of scarcity leads to a struggle for mankind. In an economy, we have to decide how to use the scarce resources like skilled workers, capital or machines, land and other resources, so that we can maximize the satisfaction of the people. So this is the main thrust to the subject, and all the efforts in trying to analyze economic problems is about how to get maximum satisfaction from scarce resources. Once we have decided how to distribute our resources among the various activities, the next problem would be how to distribute the output or the product that we have produced among the people in such a manner that satisfaction is maximized. Maximization of satisfaction is taken to be equivalent to maximization of welfare. And therefore, the next problem would be how to distribute these goods that we have produced in a manner that will maximize our satisfaction. As I said earlier, scarcity is the main problem which leads us to try to analyze this and to make an effort to maximize our satisfaction. Given the scarce resources which have alternate uses, we must try to put them to the best of use in order to maximize welfare.